Hello, NYO-U. My name is August Haller, and I'm a horn player from Brooklyn, New York. And I'm extremely lucky to have been selected to be a part of the 2017 National Youth Orchestra of the United States of America, going to Latin America this summer. And I don't think I've been more excited about anything in my life. In this video, I'd like to give you a few tips on how to blend with your section. Blending is a very important skill as a musician. Being able to fit inside your section mate sound is, in my opinion, what differentiates a good ensemble from a great one. Tip number one, be aware. The first thing you need to do to be able to blend successfully is make sure you are always self-aware. Always be listening to the musicians around you and watching the conductor. It can be very easy to get lost in the music and bask in the wonderful sounds of the musicians around you, especially when playing a piece as awesome as Mahler's First Symphony. This is something that happens to me way too often. But you need to force yourself to be really focused. This is so you can pick up on all the subtle colors and details played by your colleagues, and this will allow you to better blend and match your colleagues' musicality and sound. Tip number two, be in tune. This may seem like a no-brainer, but it's such an essential part of blending that I deemed it necessary to include. I mean, how can you expect to sound like your section mates if you have different wavelengths coming out of your instrument? One thing that helps me a lot is to practice with a drone. Now, I advocate using a drone instead of a tuner because it forces you to pay attention to your own sound and it trains your ears rather than your eyes. I always keep a drone on my music stand when I warm up, as well as whenever I need to tune a particular passage in music. Now, there are some free apps that work great for this, but I decided to splurge and buy an album on iTunes called Cello Drones. It's about $10. And it's a cello playing for 7 minutes in every single key. There are many ways to work on intonation, so just do whatever works best for you. Tip number three, learn what's going on in the piece. It is essential to learn the structure and the voicing of the piece in order to blend. At any point, you should be able to ask yourself, what is my role at this particular moment? And you should have a definitive answer. For example, if you have a supporting role, you should come back a bit. Or if you have the melody, you should bring it out more. One section where it is crucial to know your role is the third movement of Beethoven's Ninth Symphony, the fourth horn solo. Even though on the page it looks like just a bunch of long notes, in reality this section is so tricky. This is because you change roles multiple times within a couple of lines of music. One way that helps me learn what my job is to listen to recordings and follow along with the score of every piece I have to play. Following along with just your own part or all the parts of your section even is not enough. It doesn't show you how the music pieces together and how exactly you should fit in. It also helps me a lot to learn the background of a piece. Maybe the piece has some important symbolism, or maybe the time period in which it was written affected the composer's choices in some way. Tip number four, adjust your tone color. The next thing you need to do is adjust the color of your sound in order to fit the style and mood of the piece you are on. It's not enough to just be in tune with your neighbors. You have to sound like one instrument. Horns probably have the most tools at our disposal to change color. We have our right hand, a plethora of alternate fingerings, even our embouchure, and therefore we are given many opportunities where we need to be able to change color at a minute's notice. However, every instrument has some way to adjust their timbre, and therefore we as musicians have to be able to change it as needed. Tip number five. One last tip that might not be so obvious at first is to really bond and connect with your section. Really getting to know your fellow musicians and creating that strong emotional connection really creates a much tighter ensemble. Whether you know it or not, your emotion is going into your playing. Bonding as a section helps you learn how to tell what and how your section mates are feeling. This helps you play in sync with one another. It's up to you as a member of the section to actively try and create these bonds. Make every member feel like they belong and are a part of the group. Build mutual respect for one another. Offer choice, in other words, show support. And most importantly, be empathetic and understanding. Help your teammates get through and put behind them whatever troubles may occur. So to quickly summarize, my five tips for blending with a section. Number one, be aware. Listen carefully to yourself and your colleagues to pick up all their details and their sounds. Number two, be in tune. Drones are your best friend. Number three, learn what's going on in the piece. Know your role at any given moment. Don't just know your part, know the entire piece. Number four, adjust the color of your sound to match the people around you and fit the style of the piece. And number five, bond and connect with your fellow musicians. Try to be the best person you can be. Radiating good vibes is contagious and really helps bring people together. Once again, I'm August, and thank you so much for watching this video on how to blend with your section. If you found this video useful or helpful in any way, shape, or form, I encourage you to subscribe by clicking the button right here. You should also check out all the other videos on this channel, as my colleagues have a ton of great stuff to say. Anyways, until next time, happy practicing!